really embarrassing. Day like today, I think it's very special for all of us, very special for the city. For us to play the way that we did, especially in the second half, is unacceptable. Nobody's going to come. Nobody's going to save us. We have nobody coming to the door. Tomorrow is going to change what we're doing. We got guys down. We've got 8 or 9, 10 guys that can suit up. We need everybody to find it in themselves. So, get us out of this thing, and today was not us.
So what do you do if it's unacceptable? You guys got the team leading, and so the defense seems to change as a result of that. What has to change?
We got to find a way to change our mindset. We got to believe again, more so than anything. We've had the same group of guys that was here before. We were here when we were 12-5. Lineup hasn't changed that much. Guys are still playing. We're playing then. It's just about our confidence. It's about guys understanding that we can win the game regardless of runs. Being, down 9, 10 points in games. We used to, fight through that. Right now we kinda hold our head and we feel like the game is over, so then it 2-3 in a row. But we turn the ball over. We gotta keep encouraging each other, keep working in practice. Like I said, there's no formula, there's nobody coming to the board that's gonna make a difference that's gonna change us overnight. We had to do it ourselves.
Here a long time, obviously. Can you think of a regular season long? I mean, given the stage that's sort of hit me like this one?
Not many, man. It felt like we lost the last game 7 in the playoff to me. Like the season, it meant that much. And it's hard. Like I said, this game means a lot for me, for my teammates, for the city, and for us not to show, with that effort that we should have had to win tonight is, a lot of it falls on me and as a leader of the team, and I got to be better, preparing guys for this game, and just feel awful about losing it.
Is it effort or is it horsepower at this point? Is it healthy, talented bodies? Is it? I mean, even if you had the effort?
Yeah, we give effort. It's consistent. The consistency of it. We play really hard. We practice really hard. We've got great guys in our locker room. Sometimes, some nights, you don't have enough talent to beat another team. But we haven't given ourselves those chances to show that, to feel like when we lost the game, we gave everything. We had every single guy. Some games, some guys do better than, other games. But we need everybody to give that same fight every single night in order to give ourselves a chance. And we've got guys down, we've got guys hurt away from the team, and unique situation, so we just had to fight through it.
So this home stand feels like it's critical to get it figured out during this stretch?
It's very critical right now. It's very critical. We've got a great opportunity in front of us being at home. We've got winnable games. We've got games that, we can get our confidence back and get guys playing at that high level they were playing earlier in the year. We've got to find it here at home, if not anywhere. And we want to keep our fans engaged. We want to keep them behind us. And, like performances like tonight is not something that keeps people coming back. And we understand that. And we want to, try to continue to give them a reason to come support.
Coach used the term broken spirit. Talk about where the team's at right now. Do you agree with that? Deal with that?
Individuals, I think we all feel certain, certain ways about everything. Everybody has something individually going on, it seems like. And it happens when you lose. Everything seems to come to the forefront. We've got, it's easy to break apart in situations where there's adversity. I've been in locker rooms where it has. But this team, regardless of that, we've still found a way to still try to hold each other accountable, still try to do the right things. We just got to take it to one more level, just do one more of everything that we're trying to do and accomplish. And, it's hard. We've been through a lot in the last month as a team, on and off the court, as far as organization is concerned and our team. So, we were just trying to battle through it and keep guys' spirits as high as we can.
We had a team meeting a couple weeks ago. I mean, is there anything else that's left to work on at this point or to try again?
There's nothing left to talk about. We have no no more meetings is going to fix anything. It's about doing it. It's about working. It's about, you know, looking yourself, you know, in the mirror and saying, what can I do to change this myself? Individually, what can I do, you know, whether I'm a defender or a shooter or a rebounder, be the best me I can be. For me, be the best leader I can be, you know, be engaging, be aggressive, all the things that I can do to make the team better. I think each individual guy is, we're at that point where you can't say any more things to each other right now. We've said everything, so it's about action.
Mike, do you have any sense from the franchise about how long the leash is sort of on the status quo now before maybe there's some big-time organizational changes?
Like, game aside, you know, you guys coming out, I have the Dream shirts on. I mean, talk about what that means to you.
It means a lot. It means a lot, you know. I've been in the city my whole career, and, you know, being in Indiana growing up, I didn't understand as much as I probably should have what Dr. King meant and his impression on the world today. So to be able to play on his day is an honor, especially in this city, where, you know, the I Am a Man, the sanitation workers, the strike, everything that was going on at that time was right here, you know, where we stand, and that's powerful, and it's an honor to suit up and be able to play and just honor him, because I wouldn't be able to do it. A lot of these guys wouldn't be able to do it had he not, you know, took that stand so many years back.
One more, Mike. I got one more for you real quick, Mike. Because you've been here for 10 years and participated in this game all those years, have you gotten kind of a deeper understanding of Dr. King and his legacy and everything, more so than, say, your first year? Are you still learning things about him?
Yeah, I am. I'm learning things about him. You know, I'm learning about everything back in the Civil Rights Movement. Every year I go to the Civil Rights Museum a couple times a year, and every single time I come out, it's like I learn a whole side of things. Something, you know, more specific about that time period and how it affected us today. So it's like I said, it's just been an honor to have lived in the city and gotten to really get close to Dr. King and his message and what, you know, he believed in.
Thanks, Mike.